Now let me just you know, we have just 2 to 3 minutes, so I just want to ask one comment very briefly from you, and I'll start Vivek ji from you. Is we all know the problem, we all understand those issues. Now if one thing which has to be done differently, as Dr. Amol said, that Dr. Chitalkar has a counter thinking approach, you have to do something very differently. Now what would be that, very briefly, maybe in a line or two line, all the panelists, if you can just quickly share, start with you, Vivek, what is one thing that has to be done differently if you want to improve access and support in our country?
So I think both the things have been covered, and I would just want to emphasize, first, bring patient voice at the center of the podium in the discussions, every discussion. Even patient voice should not be a separate session in conference. It should be in the middle of the session, in the starting of the session, when every oncologist, every policymaker listen. And you guys, being, as Varnaji said, our leaders, and being in such a strong position, you can change that. And second one is clinical trial. Again, if you leading oncologist, the pharma companies would start to bring together and speak, I can vouch that patients are not dying because of clinical trial. Patients are dying because they are not having access to clinical trials. I see hundreds of requests, and I can show the evidence every week that where is clinical trial available. And when I speak either with government or pharma companies or respected oncologists, 90% response are they are not interested or they are not aware. So this thing has to change, and it has to change from our house, from our clinic, and from this conference.
Very, very pertinent. Vijay, over to you. Same question. What is that one thing should be done differently?
I would say we should teach our patients to embrace technology. And that is a great way of spreading their voice. And not only technology, I think social media is also a very, very important tool. So I would say technology and social media.
Very right. Vandana ji, what would be that one thing from your side? You have to unmute, please.
I agree with Vivek that, you know, clinical trials have to be brought to the country. But I also feel that why are clinical trials designed and by whom? Why is the patient's voice not taken even in the designing of the clinical trial? Patient or a patient representative or somebody should be there who can talk from the point of a patient. A doctor, doctors sit together, pharma companies sit together, each one has their interest in designing of that trial. But the person who's going to be affected by the trial is not a part of that trial. So I think even before the clinical trials are brought to the country, this aspect has to be looked into. And secondly, the patients have to be empowered. Our patients still treat the doctors as God. Because, and they do not have the power to ask a single question, you know, they don't want to challenge the doctor. So as support groups, each one of us has to make sure that our patients are so empowered that they can challenge a doctor. They can ask questions. Why are they going to be put on a trial? Why is this medicine being given? There's no answer because the doctors don't have more than 2 minutes to answer them. Unfortunately, you know, I'm not saying the doctors don't have the inclination. It's just our population and our doctor ratio is so lopsided that all these problems come.
Thank you, Vandana. Now, I'll move with the same question quickly to Dr. Pallavi, to you, please.
I think we've already covered the aspects of technology, social media, and, you know, like clinical trials, not just, the patient party side of the things or the medical industry side of the things, but also what the patient has to say. But I think to do that, for all of this, we also need to speak the patient's language. So that is one thing that I would like to stress upon. In my observation, we might have technology, we might have social media, but we're not able to bring those stories from rural India in front of urban India or in front of people who can solve these issues just because of the language barrier. There is so much of, there is this inferiority complex that I have observed.
So got it. I will just stop you because we are running very late. But very important point is the information in a form which people, will be able to understand. And then if we go to Alpana ji, with all the experience that you had, what would be that one learning that as cancer groups, you know, we should learn from rare disease community doing advocacy, policy advocacy?
So I would say strategic partnership with patient voice, inclusion, not only inclusion of patient voice, inclusion in terms of creating strategic partnership right from drug development phase, that is clinical trial to treatment access. And this partner should be at all the levels with all the stakeholders. So interest of time, that is what I would say. And thank you. Thanks so much.